Kia ora, good evening. New Zealand is in a recession following two consecutive quarters of negative growth. In the first 3 months of the year, the economy contracted by 0.1%. And following a 0.7% decline in the final 3 months last year, this is where we've landed. It's all measured using gross domestic product data, the total value of the goods and services produced here. The last time New Zealand slipped into a recession was briefly, for two quarters during the height of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020. And before that, for six straight quarters in 2008 and 2009 during the global financial crisis. With more on what's triggered this recession and the expected impact, here's Dewi Preece.
Even at your local sushi spot, we've been feeling the pinch.
My customers are like a family. You know, it's really hard to say, I have to price up again.
He's been serving sushi for 20 years, but says the costs of supplies and fewer patrons are making things harder than ever. Today's GDP figures confirming the situation.
This is the red light flashing, telling us that tougher times could be ahead.
This is an afterpay economy. Borrow now, pay next generation.
This is part of a global economic downturn. New Zealand's not immune from those things.
Why is that behind me?
This Māori-run optometrist says they could be looking at a 25% drop in business.
We talk about impact on profit, but the reality is Māori business owners are thinking about their staff, they're thinking about their whānau, they're thinking about their staff's whānau. It's extraordinarily difficult.
Manufacturing, construction and hospitality also trending down.
Everyone is feeling the pinch, but those that are in those particular industries are feeling it more so than anything.
Kiwi Bank economists are forecasting the first significant increase to the unemployment rate in years, from 3.4% currently to more than 5% by next year.
Across the board, that national average is going to go up.
Inflation's also been rising, hurting Kiwis at the checkout.
Every time I go to the grocery store, I'm like, what?
I struggled to pick out meals and stuff without breaking the bank.
A silver lining in today's figures, though, more evidence we've likely passed the peak.
We should hope and we should be confident that interest rates will not rise further from here. And if anything, we can now look forward to, hopefully, this recession being relatively short-lived.
And some sectors are already getting back on track.
Oh, it's been fantastic. We're back to pre-COVID levels.
The return of cruise ships and the newly built convention centre, just the ticket for Christchurch's tourism operators.
The Kiwis are nice people. We have very good experience here.
Probably been here a dozen times, but today's the first time we're doing the tourist things.
There's a continual movement of people into the city, which is fantastic for all of us.
With the Women's World Cup about to bring even more tourists to our shores, she's feeling confident. Others, though, not as optimistic, as they eye up a rocky few months ahead. Dewi Preece, One News.